last cooking journey. I hope you've seen both of my vacation vlogs, and if not seen it, please do and go and watch it. So today I'm going to make my grandmother's special and really tasty and easy payasam, and it's made out of carrots. Can you believe, carrot payasam? Yes, you heard it right. Today I'm going to make carrot payasam, which is really tasty and is really simple also. So come on, let's see how to make my grandmother's simple and special carrot payasam. So to start with, the main ingredient of course is carrot. Over here I am taking 1 kg of carrot. So this carrot we have to cut from the head and the tail, and you have to scrape the skin off it, okay, and then we have to boil it. You have to cut the top portion like this and the tail portion, which is the below one, and scrape the skin. And then we have to cut the carrots into half like this, which will become 2 carrots. So in goes my carrot, which was scraped, cut from the top and the bottom. And now into the cooker, 1 cup of normal water will also go. Okay, so 1 cup of water, normal water. And then we'll pressure cook it for 4 whistles on high flame. Now we'll wait for the carrots to be get cooked. So while the carrots are getting cooked, over here I'm boiling 1 liter of milk. Now this 1 liter of milk has to be half liter when it is boiling. That means when the milk is boiling, it should reduce to half liter. So over here I'm using normal milk. Over here we get, you know, fresh milk from the cow. So it is normal milk. And now we have to wait for the milk to get reduced to half liter. And then we would be needing 250 grams of sugar for 1 kg of carrots. So 4 whistles have come now. Now we are going to off the gas and let the carrots cool down. So the milk has reduced to half liter. And after the carrots cool down completely, we will be making a puree out of it. So my carrots have completely cooled down. Now I am going to put the carrots in the mixer jar along with the water which was used to boil the carrots. Now we won't be putting entire carrots all together. We will be putting little by little. And then 1 more ingredient is there, which is, and another secret ingredient that my grandmother uses is roasted rice powder. Now this is added to thicken the payasam. Now over here I am using Brahmin's roasted rice powder. You can use any rice powder, okay. Now the roasted rice powder is easily available in all the supermarket. So from here I am using 2 tablespoons of roasted rice powder, 1 tablespoon and the second. Now we will coarsely grind it. It should not be fine paste, it should be coarsely ground. So see, it has become like a, you know, coarse paste. Now we'll put the rest of the carrots. If you want, you can add little more of water, but don't make it into a fine puree, it should be coarse, so that we can, you know, get small pieces of carrots when we are having the payasam. So all the carrots have been pureed. Take a saucepan or any pan. The pan should be kept on low flame and put 2 teaspoons of ghee. Now we'll put the carrot puree. Give a nice mix. Okay, mix it nicely. You can hear my grandmother's voice behind because she's guiding me, you know, because it's her recipe. Now in goes the milk, which was reduced to 1/2 liter. So pour it carefully. Give a nice mix, okay? Everything should be mixed nicely, okay? Then we'll add 250 grams of sugar. So much sugar. Mix it nicely. Now we will wait till it starts boiling. In between, you should stir it and you should keep it on low flame, okay? So over here, I have taken 5 tablespoons of milk powder. Now into this, I will be adding little bit of milk and mix it nicely. It should be nice and creamy. So I've used warm milk and the texture should be nice and creamy and there should not be any lumps. Okay, see. Okay. Now we will add this to the paisam. So it is like condensed milk only, but it is milk powder. Mix it nicely. Okay. And I've increased the flame into high flame. Now let it cook for 5 to 10 minutes, but keep on stirring in between. After some time, you can reduce the flame into medium flame. So here is my grandmother. She is making food and guiding me. So after 5 to 10 minutes, our paisam is ready. Now we'll add some fried cashews. So my paisam is ready. Everybody is in the kitchen by getting my grandmother's paisam ka smell. So here, see, nice aroma has come. Now let's serve it into a nice serving bowl. So my carrot paisam is ready. Do try this, like and subscribe my channel. And till then, bye. Do watch my vacation vlogs. So till then, subscribe, like, comment and do try this.